gender equality should begin in mother's womb. For instance, having a son or a daughter should be a matter of chance. However, technologies like ultrasound are now being used to detect the sex of the unborn child. So now, having a son or a daughter is a matter of choice and not chance. What happens when there are strong son preferences and parents can detect the sex of the child? It leads to the deliberate elimination of girls through sex-selective abortions. Apart from neglect of female health, sex-selective abortions is one of the main reasons why there are 100 million fewer women in developing countries of sub-Saharan Africa and South Asia. India alone has 25 million fewer women. Now, gender discrimination in India is rooted in cultural reasons, for instance, patriarchal and patrilineal societies, and economic reasons. Parents view sons as incentives for insurance for old age, and daughters are expensive because of the tradition of dowry, which refers to huge amounts of wealth given to the groom's family by the daughter's father. I mean, yes. So as a result, 2,000 girls have been aborted in India since every day since the 1990s. To address this issue, the Indian government put a legal ban on detecting the sex of the child before birth and made it a punishable offense in 1996. The goal of my research is to look at the intended and unintended effects of putting a legal ban on detecting the sex of the child. So, using household level data that reports the entire birth history of women, I find that the policy led to a 5% increase in the probability of female birth. This is exactly what the policy intended to do. However, it had an unintended effect. It led to the worsening of female health. That is, in terms of weight, girls were 11.9% more likely to be malnourished, and in terms of height, they were 12% more likely to be stunted. This indicates that parents who could have aborted unwanted girls earlier are now substituting gender-based elimination of girls before birth for gender discrimination after birth. They are responding by investing fewer resources in the unwanted girls and discriminating against them. So, one policy recommendation could be that the government should incentivize parents to have girls by investing in their education and employment opportunities. Poor health in childhood can affect their long-run cognitive ability and hence their earnings. Thank you.